Okay, now let's talk about what's the real implication of the globalization, right? What globalization matter? Globalization is the ever increasing interaction, interconnectedness, and integration of people, company, and country, right? When China opened the door, right, to welcome the foreign companies, set up the subsidiary to invest there. Okay, what happened to them? What happened to them? Ever increasing interaction. Why? In the first, I want to say, in the first 5 years, you know, in 1989, Tiananmen Square, no, Tiananmen Square disaster, right? Something happened. So many Western companies don't like to invest in China. But Hong Kong, Taiwan company, yeah, been so near, and a similar culture and language. So they know how to build a relationship with government, right? With the local partner, right? So okay, no problem. They still went to China, right? So from 1990 to 1994, within that 4 years, many Taiwan company and Hong Kong company and Singapore company, they overseas Chinese, right? Overseas Chinese, they went to China and helped China to build up their infrastructure, right? They donate for university, they build the railway, the highway for China. Because at that time, China government was poor, right? So at that time, when this company went there, and the government give them incentive to do business with the stay warm company, you know? Stay warm company. This company warm by the central government, you know, there are many stay warm company, they won by central government, they won by provincial government, you know, yeah, stay warm company, yes. So because China is a communist country, right? Communist country, yeah. And so at that time, many small companies cannot really make a lot of profit. But the big company, they really make profit. Like Unipresident, like Master Kong, right? Many of these traditional manufacturing company, they make profit in China. So after 5 years, more and more Western multinational company know that, oh yeah, still some company can make money in China, right? So then they try to enter China that time. So many Western people, they visit China since 1906, yeah. And you know, McDonald's, Kentucky Fried Chicken, right? Yeah, start enter China. So, yeah, more and more Western companies set up their subsidiary in China. And more internet manager work there. You know Microsoft? Yeah, Microsoft. 1996, they not only enter China, but also set up the R&D center there in China, R&D center. Okay. So, yeah, this kind of globalization, the ever-increasing interaction, right? Action. So Bill Gates, you know Bill Gates? Yeah. Visit China, 1996. Yeah. So, now, know the China government leader. They build very good relationship with Microsoft. So sometimes when this their prime minister, right, or their president went to USA, the first station will stop Seattle, and host by Bill Gates. Okay. So, you know, many China political leader, they not only build a relationship with the U.S. political leader, also with the big company CEO. Okay. So, yeah, now in China, wow, every year, 100,000 U.S. students, right, U.S. students study there. Every year, 100,000 students, they study in China. Okay. Not include the European student, no. But I think even the 5 times of Korean student, more and more Korean student, yeah, they study in China University, right? No. Many Korean students, they study in China since not undergraduate, the junior high school student, study to speak Chinese, Korean, right? Very neat. Yeah, just cross the border. So now you can find why Samsung can, right? Samsung can be the number one, right, smartphone company, right, in China, right? The top one market share, right? China. Many Korean, right? They can speak Chinese, work there, okay? International business continues to grow in terms of the enterprise conducting business across border, right? So FDI and the value of the trade between the country, okay? They, FDI, you know? FDI, they set up their subsidiary and invest the manufacturing facility, no? Yeah, it's FDI. And the value of the trade between the country, grow. Okay, so the increased number of firm whose ownership is held by a firm from another country now. You know the Volkswagen, Volkswagen, yeah. The number one car company is Volkswagen in China. In China, Volkswagen, no? Not Benz, not Toyota, no. Not some, yeah. Volkswagen. So, because Volkswagen formed a joint venture, 50-50, with the Shanghai one Shanghai car company, okay. So it's very popular in China, Volkswagen, okay. And you know, 4 years ago, 2009, the China, one China car company, Geely, you know, Geely acquire Volvo, you know, V-O-L-V-E, Volvo, you know this company, Swiss, right, Volvo, sorry, Sweden, Volvo, yeah, Swiss. Yeah, Sweden, 来 Sweden car company. The company acquired by China Chile. Okay. And before, you know why this company was acquired by Chile? Because it almost bankrupt in 2009, right? Because of the economy crisis, right?But after GE acquired Volvo, this company's share, right, grow very rapidly in China market, in China market, okay? So Volvo is the China car company now, right? Do you know that? You can imagine that, right? Mm.You know Nissan, Nissan not a Japanese company. Oh, it's a French. You know, acquired by a French company. Do you know? By Renault. You know? You don't know that. Okay, so this is the globalization. And you know now the top one.High-tech company in Taiwan is the TSMC, you know? TSMC. But the ownership of TSMC, 70% of TSMC owned by foreign investor. Right? Not the Taiwan. No. Okay. So as a result of this international acquisition and partnership, the international firm product and service is becoming...ever more difficult to identify. Okay? So increase the intensity of competition placed a great pressure on the firm to develop the capacity to operate at low cost and with greater speed, quality customer service and innovation, both at home and abroad, right? Apple, Samsung, right? Wow, they compete, right? With...The pressure, right? The great pressure, right? They need to provide a low price product with great speed, quality customer service, and innovation, right? How can they do that? Right? How can they do that? How can Samsung compete with Apple, right?HR, very important, right? Marketing manager from USA, right? R&D professional from many countries, Japan, right? Japan, USA, and some from Taiwan, okay? So HR is called upon to recruit, select, develop, retain the workforce talent, then can achieve this, global competitiveness, right? Right?So how can Samsung compete, even outperform many smartphone companies, right? Because their HRM practice very successful. Right? They not only send their candidate, right? This global talent candidate, right? To have one more year, right? Study in foreign country to study there, right? And then they also attract many international professional in terms of R&D, marketing, right? Work for them, okay. So internet business no longer only the domain of large firm,from the large or developed country. You see that Samsung case, right? Korea is not a developed country, right? It's just a new industrialized country. Okay, so now let's talk about some strategic decision, right, to go international, okay? How do the various HR practitioners play the strategic role in M&E, multinational enterprise, okay? So What should IHR people do? What should they do? IHR people. First, there are some senior HR executives, right? Most of them work in headquarters. Okay? They are an active participant in the development of the global strategy and guide the firm in terms of global talent management issue. So HR head executive, right, take the responsibility, right, to help the company to form their international strategy. They are the partner, right? If this company decide to enter Indian market, okay, how can we acquire the Indian talent, right? Work for us. The HR head, right? Yeah. He need to collect a lot of information, right? Of the India. Okay. And then, second, the senior HR executive develop the HR strategy with the global HR team. The global HR strategy plan support the corporate strategy objective. Yeah. So when you want to set up this international strategy, yeah, how to achieve this strategic objective, right, in the worldwide operation? How can they achieve? Yeah, so very important. HR executive, right? They need to work, right, with the global HR team. Global HR team. Who is the global HR team? Not only the function manager of HR department in the home country, also include the HR manager, right? HR manager in foreign subsidiary, right? Okay? Many HR head was located in regional center, right? In regional center. And then each business unit, regional and country HR unit develop an HR work plan to achieve the HR strategic objective and develop metric to evaluate timely result. Okay? Yeah, so the China HR, right, manager, okay, to help, right, to make the plan, okay, the HR plan. Got it? Okay. Now, there are four types of IHR management practice. Four types. I leave this for you to learn. External-centric. External-centric. What do you mean? External-centric.
They focus on regional markets. Focusing on regional markets.
Yeah, yeah.
And for one culture.
Yeah, one culture. And most of their manager, international manager.
They're from the same country.
Yeah, from the home country, right? The home country. And a polycentric. Polycentric. You know, polycentric? Anybody know? Anybody know? Do you know polycentric? Poly? Yeah. So, how they compose their international manager? From home country or? Yeah. Yeah. The local, right? No, more local manager. Okay? Polycentric. Do you know Japanese company is the polycentric or ethnocentric? Huh? Poly?
Similar.
Ethno.
They kind of keep their stuff within their borders a lot.
Yeah. Japanese cannot decentralize the authority, right, to the foreign subsidiary. Right.
It seemed like they were expanding more to China until the riots.
Yeah.
Last year, 2 years ago. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So most of the Japanese company, they use ethnocentric strategy. They can they can employment many local manager, but they can this manager local manager cannot become CEO in foreign subsidiary, right? Yeah. So, do you like to work in Japanese company? Okay. But hire many China company hire, but this China company can become successful in the global market because of this polycentric policy, HR policy. They can leverage it, right, the US manager. Right. Regiocentric. What mean? Regiocentric. You know? Regional centric. It means this multi companies are many regional centers, right? Asia region center. Europe region center, right?
The managers from one company work abroad.
Yeah.
From their home country, they go abroad and work there, but they don't recruit managers from another country.
So this within this region, mm-hmm. Yes, manager, right, work only within this region, right? They will be transferred abroad, but only limited in this region subsidiary. Okay, so HR practice, HR standard, HR policy was established only for this region, right? To get the coordination benefit, right? Geocentric. Yeah.
They hire people from the country where they want.
Yeah, yeah. Even the China manager can become the CEO of the headquarters, got it? Even the US manager can become the CEO in Japan Samsung, right? Got it? This is a geocentric, okay? So I don't need to explain the detail, you just leave for your reference, okay? So, now, if your company want to become a geocentric company, okay, you need to develop a global mindset inside the HR function. Right? You cannot be a China HR mindset, right? China mindset. Your HR cannot be. You need to have a global mindset, okay? And you need to align the core HR process activity, right, with the new requirement of company globally, okay. While simultaneously responding to local issue and requirement. It means that if you want to respond to the local issue requirement, you need to recruit manager from the host country, right? However, if you want to align the core HR process, right, with the new requirement of competing global, all these local managers need to be transferred, right, to be developed in other country. They need to have international experience, right? Okay. Then enhancing global competence and capability within the HR function. Yeah. Even the HR professional, HR people also need to be located, right? From the headquarters to the foreign subsidiary, or from foreign subsidiary to the headquarters. Okay? Yeah. Now, let's check this map. To know how the HIM operate. Within this country A, for example, in Taiwan, okay? Country A, the S form, right? Acer, okay. In Acer company, there are many expatriates, right? Was assigned to work in China, right? In Philippines, in Malaysia, okay? In Russia, okay? Pay PCM, parent, no? PCM, parent countries, right? Nation, right? Parent country, nation. So PCM, there are some manager assigned, right? Assigned to work in China, in Russia, okay. And even some European manager, okay, or some, no, they are impatriate. It means that the local manager can be transferred to work in the headquarter. So in Asia headquarter, in Acer headquarter, you can find many, some Italian, some German, okay? Some US Caucasian work there, okay? Even HTC, yeah, HTC, yeah, same situation. And then, in Taiwan, you can find another company, Samsung, okay, or DuPont. Many modern companies in Taiwan, they set up subsidiary here, right? So, but for example, DuPont. Do you know DuPont? Chemical, the top one chemical company in the world, the U.S. company, DuPont. D-U-P-O-N-T, DuPont. You know? DuPont. Okay? So this company set up subsidiary in Taiwan. And after 20 years, many Taiwanese managers become the global manager. Right? And they was assigned and work in headquarters to handle the world business. No? Especially the electronic business. Yeah, right? And also you can find ASUS. ASUS? In ASUS headquarters, you can find many foreign R&D professionals. There are almost 3,000 R&D professionals work in the headquarters of ASUS in Taipei. Right. And some of them come from India, right? Come from other countries. And do you know TSMC, right? Oh, same situation. There are many famous scientists work for TSMC from USA, right? Got it? So there's some TCNs, immigrant, okay? Got it? So how is the global expansion of the firm serving its employee and customer? Yeah. So now many Western company want to do business in China, okay? Expansion. How, yeah, this is serving your employee and customer. How? Okay, think about it. Yeah, so how to develop the HIM practice? First, establishing an international HR strategy, and you should know the difference between international and domestic HIM. Domestic, right? Domestic. And development of the HIM function. Okay, so you should first establish an HR strategy. Country selection is very important. Right? If you want to set up a foreign subsidiary for marketing or for R&D, right, or for manufacturing. Yeah, where? Where? How can you recruit and hire the people, right, the employee, right? And it will need a competitive wage. Right. You can set up an IT R&D center in India, right? India, okay? Only maybe now only 30% the wage of USA, right? But their competence, right? Maybe 80% of the US right? Engineer, okay? Global staffing, yeah. So how to recruit? How many employees will need to be relocated to the foreign location? Yeah, or will necessary people be found locally? Right. I illustrate for you when GMA manufacturing, GMA TFT LCD manufacturer, right? Right, TFT LCD, right? When they set up the new manufacturing subsidiary in China, they assign 150 engineers to go there and recruit almost 3 times the local engineer, right? And give them training, right? And then they can manage it, 10,000 employees. 10,000 work, got it? So, yeah, stage by stage. Global staffing. Recruitment and selection, yeah. What will be required to find and recruit the necessary talent to make the new international operation successful, right? When you want to select an intelligent manager, you need to check his competence, right? His cross-cultural awareness, okay? His cross-cultural sensitivity, you know? Yeah. So how to see that? How to see that? When you assign an international manager work for you in a foreign subsidiary, this is a very serious matter, right? It matters a lot. Okay. If he is incompetent, right? He's not capable. Then all the foreign subsidiary will fail. Okay. Compensation. Yeah, how to motivate, right? Compensate this intelligent manager, right? They should get higher compensation, right? Higher compensation. And a standardized OR adaptation, okay? So the same HR policy used in the foreign subsidiary work or not? The same HR, right, policy, same HR function, sometimes need adaptation, right? Sometimes standardization, okay? Right? For example, when you want to recruit a manager in the local context, this managerial level should be standardization. Right? Yeah. However, for the operation level, right? Yeah. And even the compensation policy, right? Compensation policy should be more adapted to the local context, right? The different standard of the living level, right? Okay. So, how to differentiate the international versus the domestic HIM. For the IHIM, more HR function activity, right? You want to assign an international manager, wow, HR people need to do a lot of the thing for him, okay? A broader perspective and expertise. You are not only the expertise of the domestic HR, also need to be, right? The expert, right? The expert of the HR, right? You should know the different countries, the employment law, right? Or the, their culture differences. And more involvement in people's life, right? When they go there, how to accommodate? When you come here, right? Oh, do you have any orientation? Did you? Not yet? Not yet? You have? One day? Okay. It's easy just live in this campus, right? You will know how to get along with the monkey, and no. Okay. And dealing with managing a much wider mix of employee, yeah. That I said, in one country, PCN, SCN, TCN, the third country national, okay. If you visit Shanghai, or you can find in one company, there are many different cultural background employees work together in Shanghai. Okay? Yep, I don't want to go further, but I will stop here and give you a 20-minute break. Everybody go outside, take break, and then come back. 10:50, okay? And had a 20-minute discussion, okay? Yeah, for this question, remember the question? I give to you. No, the question?